Welcome. Today is Sunday, June 28th, 9 p.m. Eastern, episode 236 of The Sundering. What do we have on deck for you tonight? Well, we have bacon news and news about stupid people, Warcraft, Diablo, Foffs, a guest speed interview because we have a very awesome guest on our show tonight, and much more. Welcome to The Sundering. We do need to point out before we start that something really strange has been going on. It's been kind of bugging us. You see, one time a man came up to us and he was holding this briefcase, stopped us, and he said, lovely weather we're having, but not as nice as in Sweden. Was he a spy? Or maybe we're spies?
The Sundering is an explicit podcast, which may not be suitable for children, people with delicate sensibilities, animals under 10 pounds, certain towns in Idaho, citizens of Liechtenstein, members of the clergy, fans of the show Cop Rock, and vegans.
The following program is closed captioned for the thinking impaired.
Well, let's start the insanity.
This is the Sundering Podcast with your host, Seraphis.
Self-replicating bacon. I don't like fat chicks cutting my hair because we wouldn't want it to get weird or anything.
Rapist.
He adds to the show and everyone gets upset. It's great.
I know. I know they say this, but I don't care.
And Zia.
Hi, Slurp. I'm so full of hate. I'm not sure what a podcast is. Slavery is different than a fish.
Show us again.
Yay! There we go. Hey! All right. So for 20 minutes, I thought I was at a Nicki Minaj concert, but in reality, I was just staring at a homeless man yelling at a pigeon. I'm Seraphis.
Aw. Was he changing, like, was he getting really loud and then he getting really close? And
there's a whole lot of weirdness going on. And as you can see, Ray is not, or is, well, if you're watching us, you can see that Ray is not here. If you're downloading us, you are now being told that Ray is not here, so.
Yeah, he's not here.
Hey, it's Ray. Go figure. You know, and then, you know, we were worried she wouldn't be able to make it tonight, but fortunately, due to a hole in the prosecution's case, it's Zia. Hey. And of course, our guest. I met him for the first time last year and roped him into helping organize the line at World of Podcast. He's probably one of the hardest core raiders we have ever had on this show. His co-host on The Edge, Maticus, I think is envious of his ability to actually get a raid together. He is going to regret coming on this show. I'm sure of it. Let's see if you can pinpoint that exact moment. Welcome, Sean, from The Edge Podcast.
Hi. Matt is going to be so pissed that you said that. And I'm going to play it over and over and over. Because since I have this backup audio going...
Well, every time I listen to your guys' show, you always be like, yeah, and we're starting to work on this. And Matt's like, can't find a damn healer.
Do you know why? It's because he plays Alliance, and Alliance sucks.
Hey, you watch your damn mouth. You watch your goddamn mouth. I'm not sure we're allowed to curse, so fuck you.
I looked at his realm, like server horde to Alliance ratio, and it's like one horde, it's like 0.2 Alliance, and I'm like, dude, you wonder why you can't find anybody. Like, so he did end up transferring, but then of course it's just kind of an old game, man. I mean, people are kind of getting into that point where they're just like, all right, I'm gonna come back in 3 weeks to a month, do what I want to do, and then I'm gonna leave and go play all x amount of amazing that other games that are out there, which you can't blame them. It's just I have a really bad addiction problem, so you know, I can't move on. It's like a really bad ex-girlfriend that you just keep Snapchatting. You don't want to. You just kind of do every now and then. And you're like, shit, I shouldn't have done that.
I don't even... I've never Snapchatted. I feel left behind.
Oh, God. All right. Please tell me at least you know what Tinder is. You know what Tinder is?
I know what Tinder is. Isn't it like you swipe right if you like it?
Right.
Yeah, all right. I know.
Well, it's usually the it is a person.
Well...
Unless you know you're really...
Well, hold on. No, not true. I've actually seen some pictures of Tinder profiles, and it's not all people. Sometimes I've seen Muppets on there.
Sick. Nice.
I saw someone post a picture of a Jawa on there. So it's not all people, in quotes. I'm sure people are putting them up, but they're not all people. I even saw one for the target dog. Someone put the target dog up there. And it said that it likes doggy style. So, I mean...
That's clever. See, yeah. Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, we're on the same page.
All right.
Either way, Matt can be pissed. I just want to reiterate that. So, He's gonna make a big post on Blizzard Watch about how he's mad at you.
Okay. Well, look, people. I know what Snapchat is. I just never have done it.
It's all right. We all know that you're behind in the times.
I mean, I know that there's an app. And...
Well, no, you're washed up.
Have you? Do you use Snapchat?
Yeah. I send goofy cat videos to my nieces and my mom, and it's fun. Yeah. I don't use it for tits.
You're such a
cat lady. You could use it for tits, but I don't.
You're such a cat lady.
That's fun.
So you send pictures of your cat's tits to people?
Yeah.
You can milk anything with nipples.
That's true. Even kitties.
Wow.
So who's joined us in the chat room tonight?
Yeah, let's check out the chat room. We have Adam, Broom, Chef, EC, Joe B, Loki, Opus, Thunder, Toasty Posty Can, Sean, because he didn't have a choice, and a little Velvet Dove action.
I'm glad you didn't say VD this time.
Thought about it, but because I know how much you don't like it.
Well, I mean, I just feel bad for her at this point. That
no, she thinks it's fun. If it bothered her, if she said, it really bothers me, it makes me uncomfortable, I'd be like, hell no.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of like that like thing where people are like, oh yeah, I'm fine with it. And then like you like turn away and you're like, you son of a bitch.
I mean, VD does stand for vagina dysfunction, right? It's kind of like erectile dysfunction.
I thought it was venereal disease, but...
Vaginal discharge. You know, it just doesn't stand for anything nice, does it?
God damn it. Now Velvet Dove is questioning her.
Dysfunction.
Oh, she's like, why did I name myself that? God damn it. All right, so real quick, let's get the administrative things out of the way. Our ads, Amazon, Newegg, Jinx, and Groupon on our site. You click through those, you buy something on the site. We get a little cut from the man, and it's no cost to you, so we appreciate that, especially for everyone. Funny. Actually, for all you people who click through, that's actually helping us pay for our URL renewal this coming month, so thank you. iTunes and Stitcher, rate us 5 stars. It helps people find us. You know, drop us a review. We love reading your reviews. And, of course, if you're listening to Stitcher, give us a thumbs up as your favorites, all that good stuff. Ray is not here, so I'm just going to jump in here. Sean, are you drinking anything with us tonight?
You know, it's funny because I went. Okay, first of all, this is going to be a brag story. The quick answer is no, not this very second.
Okay.
The long answer is I just went on a 13-day vacation to the beach, and I drank every single day, and I was feeling really terrible by the end of it. We went through like 27 cases of beer. There was 8 of us.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, so I've been drinking a lot of water, trying to not die.
But
I am going to grab something at some point. Most likely when my dog starts going crazy, I got to go, do something with the dog. So you'll see me disappear for like 30 seconds.
Yeah, it's okay.
And then magically I'll hold it up. But it'll probably be something.
Something delicious.
Beer, some kind of beer.
Okay. Fair enough.
Straight Jack.
That sounds like a very nice vacation.
So just tell us, you know, what have you been up to the past week? Gaming, life,
vacation.
I went on vacation. I'm from North Carolina, so I went to it's a place called Carolina Beach. It's a cool place. There was a bunch of shark attacks. People lost limbs. Interesting stuff. True story. There's actually been 6 attacks in 2 weeks there, that area. So that's fun.
Oh, wow.
Let me think. What else have I been doing? Oh, 6.2 came out. Little thing in World of Warcraft. So I've been doing that. Getting rep stuff, raiding. I think the guild is like, I don't know, 100 and something in the world right now. Not that great, but we haven't really been pushing that hard either for progression. We went through normals first, then into heroics. Been still playing a lot of Heroes of the Storm, Hearthstone. Haven't really been touching Diablo or StarCraft, though. Been kind of shying away from that. And what else have I been doing? Been playing a lot of Final Fantasy.
Wait, the MMO or just...
No, I haven't gotten into Final Fantasy 14. I am going to buy it. Because I have my WoW subscription paid up until next year from the token system. So, but I've been playing Final Fantasy Record Keeper on my iPad.
Oh, I've had a couple people tell me I really need to play that.
It's good. Yeah,
I've played it a little bit. I got distracted by another game, but yeah, it is. Just holding it up. There it is.
Yeah,
it looks nice. It's, if you played any of the other Final Fantasy games, it's really good nostalgia. Just a lot of fun. Just good time killer. You know, if you like playing Candy Crush or any of those stupid games, it's that. Oh, I also found out that when I was at the beach and I was drunk, I was playing Flappy Bird, the original Flappy Bird on the beach, right?
You found it.
Wait. Was it like a real life Flappy Bird on the beach, or
we were like kicking it in the nuts, and it would just
nice. Good job. I like it.
It had to keep going through our waves of beer bottles.
I like where this is going.
Now, I don't think. People were still betting on these, like on eBay, but they're making bids on them. But apparently, like if you still have the original game on your iPhone or iPad, you can sell it for a pretty ridiculous amount of money. So iPhone 4S's were going for $600 to $700, and my iPad Mini could sell for like $1,300 because it has the original game on it. And so that was kind of cool. So I figured
Why did I not download that game?
Yep, that's boo.
I know.
Boo-bird. So that's what I've been doing. Getting drunk and playing games and occasionally going to work.
Living the dream.
That is living the dream. I like that.
It's a lot harder than it sounds, though, really. Do you know what it's like to like get up at, like, I don't know, 10? Then you're like, drink all day. On the beach where it's, like, 100 degrees. Then you're going to come in, like, you know, clean the sand off you. Play a game. Maybe, like, drink some more. It's actually harder than it sounds. It sounds fun for like a day or two. So you're doing it for like the 10th day straight.
You're just like, I don't know if I can do this anymore.
Like, I think I'm going to die. I really think I'm going to go and just pass out somewhere and not wake up ever again. Anyways, that's my life.
All right. Zia, what about yourself?
Oh, it's been a bit of a quiet week. My husband and I have figured out, we have a machine upstairs in our living room that we play. It's a computer essentially, and we play Steam games on it. And so Mark's been on like a kick downloading multiplayer Steam games. So we've been playing Expendabros, which is the Expendables, but in a side scroll pixelated shooter game. And it's apparently free, and
like
it's really,
bad dudes?
Really fun. Bad dudes? Like, I guess
I'm just thinking about
that. I never played Bad Dudes, but
it's very similar to River City Ransom.
Okay, it's like River City Ransom, but it's really not. It's not as involved as River City, where you go into shops and stuff like that. Like, it's just pure like shooting people, and pixelated form, which is really fun. And then we've been playing Castle Crashers a fair amount, and
hey, Castle Crashers.
Yeah, it's really fun.
I love that game.
Yeah, we really stumbled on it. It's really fun.
I think I have it on my Xbox One. I got it. It was part of like the freebie month last month.
I wonder if you can you play on an Xbox One with people on a PC.
Yeah, I would imagine you can. It's all client side server based. It should be fun.
Maybe?
I remember it came out, and then it pulled like a Diablo 3 and was like, nope, we're not going to work. And we're like, what the shit? Because it got released in like the middle of the night. My buddy and I stayed up and like, this game's going to be fucking awesome. We kept like staring at the website, and there's like a big countdown. We're getting super excited, but all these snacks and like Mountain Dew, we're getting all hype. You know what I mean? And then it just crashed, and we're like, this sucks.
I've been so upset.
I mean, I know Diablo 3 on console does not mix with the PC version. I know that.
Yeah.
But I don't know about, like, Castle
Blizzard. Because Blizzard, that's why.
Because Blizzard, yeah, I wish it did.
Because Blizzard's like, buy our shit in multiple platforms, you dummy.
And I did. God damn it.
And you did. See? Sucker. And, yeah, I feel like an idiot because I spent $400 on Hearthstone cards. Idiot.
Wait
a minute. I can't, can't help you out on that one.
Don't worry. We all have our vices, okay?
Yeah, we do. Other than that, Heroes of the Storm. I finally got enough gold because I haven't been putting real money into it yet, but I finally got enough gold to buy Stitches. And I love... He's so fun to play. I'm really all that great at him, but I don't give a shit. Like, he's just fun. And so I played some Heroes, and that was my sort of gaming, I guess... That was sort of my week. It was a pretty uneventful week, I'd say. Which is good, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
It's good. Oh, I did want to address something, because Joe B. brought up in the chat room about Fury Road. And he was saying that Fury Road didn't meet his expectations. And something I'd mentioned on the show a while back, but I couldn't talk about, was the fact that when I saw Fury Road, I had a hard time watching it because it's really tough to watch when you're pregnant. And
Is it, like, sensitive to, like, the grotesque stuff?
You've seen it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. There was something about, like, just seeing, well, like, spoilers for anybody who hasn't seen it, but, like, the scene where the girl gets hit by the car, but then she's in the back of the car, and they just, like, basically, like, dig into her stomach. you know, they don't really show up, but it's all in, like, insinuated that they're like doing this like C-section. Yeah. And I was just like, oh god, like, it just, I mean, she's not alive, right? But like, it was just so grizzly to me, I guess. And so the whole thing, and then like the breastfeeding chicks at the beginning, like, that was real visceral to me.
No, you need
just, and so
not viscous.
No, you need a good cry. Do you know what movie I would recommend? What? Homeward Bound.
I love that movie.
Yeah, you just need, you know, to see Chance running up and with Shadow
and Shadow
and you remember that one?
Oh, I remember that one.
Sassy.
Of course I do. I love that. Crying. There's another chance. I mean, like, every kid cry. Like, oh my gosh, that and like Land Before Time. That movie, when I was a kid, I always cried every time I watched that movie.
Land Before Time.
Yeah.
It's another dinosaur movie. Dinosaur movies apparently are a thing nowadays.
They are a thing.
Yeah, they are. What do you mean they were downplaying the scene on Mumble, Adam? Yeah, that was tough. That was a really, I mean, you know, and I don't know if it hit me differently because I am with child. And so the idea, that sounds so bizarre saying it that way. I'm not going to say that that way again.
You're growing something.
It's a hot dog. It's in there. The bun's in there warming up, and I'm going to have a hot dog. And so, yeah, it just hit me really, whoa. So, anyway, I'd meant to address that and couldn't when Joe Bree brought up the chat room. I was like, oh yeah, I meant to say something about that. Because I couldn't say it, because I hadn't revealed things yet. So, Bubby!
Hopefully yes. This doesn't bother you. I'm just going to throw this out there. But my daughter saw a pregnant woman.
Okay.
And she's like, I was in mommy's tummy, right? I was like, yes, you were. She's like, did I come out of her butt? And I'm like, god damn it.
It's time to have a little chat.
No, I was like, no, you did not. Like, you did not come out of the butt. Don't worry about it.
That's why you're a little shit. That's what you have to say. That's what I would have said. But I'm not a parent. So.
Well, I'll let her get a little older before I tell her she's a little shit. But
Did you tell her?
I told her she came out of the belly button.
Okay, that's fair.
Which is fair because it was a C-section. But
yeah, she came out of her belly. Yeah.
So I said, came out of the belly button. She's like, I have a belly button. I was like, just let's calm down. Let's watch.
Stop right there for now.
Let's watch Scooby Doo.
Isn't it time for Dora? Where's Dora?
No, my daughter has moved beyond Dora. She's now into Scooby Doo and Star Wars Clone Wars.
You guys ever watched the Bernie Mac show back in the day?
Yes.
Okay, you remember? I don't know if you remember this one episode, but
died.
Yeah, I know, it sucks because he was just so terribly awesome at what he did. It like made everyone else look bad. He was that good. Like, I love people that are so good at something that they just shit on everyone. He was that kind of guy. Well, anyways, there was one episode where his daughter caught him naked. Coming out of the shower, and he went into her bedroom to go talk to her about it, and he was so nervous, and I'll never forget the scene. It made me laugh. I almost pissed myself. I laughed so hard. He stepped on one of her like toys, and it squeaked, and it was like, he's like, damn little pigger, and he like kicked it across the room because he just, you know what I mean, he just did not want to talk about the fact that she's like, he's like, we need to talk to you, and she's like, about when I saw your penis or something like that. he's like, no, what? He's like, no, just you gotta be knocking before you come through the door. Oh, I missed that show. So good. Anyways, I just reminded me of that.
What is your puppy's name?
My puppy's name is Riley. Riley. We rescued her from the shelter. She looked very scared and sad, so we adopted her. And she is now very happy. She happy pees every time I come home.
Oh, puddles.
Yeah, she's so happy she just pisses on my foot. So it's a good time.
She's
a cool dog, though. She really is. She's awesome, but she just...
Yeah, just a thing of saran wrap outside your front door that would say, like, right before you come in, you just saran wrap your leg or something. And...
Oh, I try to run to the kitchen because it's not carpet, you know?
Yeah.
I can clean it up easier there. Yeah. That's the trick.
Gotcha. All right, well, let's roll along. So I am drinking some Evan Williams bourbon. My neighbor gave it to me because he doesn't drink bourbon, and he had it for whatever reason, and he's like, you drink it. So,
what's her name, your neighbor?
Well, her name is Paige, and her husband's name is Sean, so I mean, yeah. It's...
Oh, damn, what a cool name that is. Yeah. Must be a good guy.
So Sean gave it to me, and so I'm finishing it up here because I feel like I'm obligated to finish it now.
Yeah.
But yeah, so like I drank like a whole bunch of it over his house last night, got drunk, thank God I could just walk home. So that was nice. Big news in my life. Big news. Breaking news. I have decided to make my own pickles.
What?
I just decided to get up yesterday morning and said, I want to make my own pickles. So this
so morning, if I give you a nickel, will you tickle a pickle?
Well, I mean, that's after the show. That's after the show, Sean. After the show. I mean, I need you to just relax for about like an hour or so. But no, I just was like, you know what? I'm going to make my own goddamn pickles. So right now, I got pickles going. And surprisingly, the person most excited about this is my sister-in-law. She really wants my pickles.
Take that
however you want.
I'm sorry.
and if she's watching right now, just, you know, whatever. All right. So I have Borderlands 2 on my Xbox 360, but I was contemplating buying the Borderlands Humble Bundle. I don't know if you saw this. But it's like for $15. Like, I'm pretty sure I'm going to buy it. But for $15, you get Borderlands 1. You get all the Borderlands 1, like, add-on, like, DLC. Then you get the Borderlands 2. You get, like, all the DLC. You get 75% off coupon for Borderlands the pre-sequel. Okay. And you also get, like, Borderlands 2 the season pass. And it's just like
for $15.
$15. So like I'm pretty sure I'm gonna do that. I'm just
considering
like,
all the DLC usually cost I think like $5 to $10 a pop. That's really good.
Yeah, I keep on staring at it. I'm like, why am I not buying it? I'm like, I should just get this. Like,
yeah.
Just so, do it, man.
I probably am.
You haven't played anything past the first one, have you?
No, I never even played the first Borderlands. I played Borderlands 2. I think I got my one of my characters up to like level 10 or something, and that's it.
Oh,
Borderlands 1 may not be for you. Maybe now it's kind of dated. So, but it's still good. But it was good for its time, kind of thing, you know. Mm. So I don't know. Maybe give it a try. I mean, I don't know.
Everyone's I think they're really fun.
So yeah. So that's probably gonna happen. Also, our Guild Phalanx of Nod on Dalaran server Alliance signed. Thank you very much. Not having any problems finding healers either, I want to point out.
Oh, shit.
That's a little stab at Matt.
A little jab there. In fact, one of our healers is in the chat room right now.
Oh.
Hey, Adams.
But wait, not having problems finding a healer. That sounds like a backward-handed... Like, that was backhanded. Because Matt's having trouble finding healers, and he's Alliance. So... Sean, do you get what I'm saying here?
I do, in fact, and I have something for you.
Okay.
That's what you get. You get the big applause.
It took me a minute.
Congratulations. Well, here's the thing with Matt. Are you familiar with a gentleman named Fidel Castro? Him and Matt are pretty good friends, and they seem to share leadership ideas with each other. So, from my understanding, Fidel Castro has a little bit of an upper hand, at least, you know, back when he was, you know, alive. And I actually met a lot of Matt's guildmates at BlizzCon, and they had some interesting stories. So,
yeah. And my leadership style is let's go kill shit, yell bacon, and drink while raiding. And so far in Hellfire Citadel, we're 4 out of 13. So I mean, we're getting hung up on Kilrog at the moment.
Yeah.
He is currently our stumbling block. Usually, I think the best we got him was 65%. Then it like. Keeps on going. It goes tits up. It goes
normal, or what are you doing?
Like we're keeping them up close to the top, and we got people running with the arrow all the way to the back towards the back of the room. Yeah. You know, as soon as you see one of those globs, you range DPS, we're taking it down. And then what just sometimes happens? It seems like we're not getting DPS once we're sending people rotating people in and out of the death zone there. We're not getting people back to kill the ads before we get too many of the hulking terrors or whatever they're called.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's a big priority system, yeah.
So, we just got to keep working at it. We'll figure it out. We're not as, like, hardcore, so I mean, we'll get it in our due time.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, that's kind of the cool thing that the game's transitioned to is you can kind of play it at the speed that you want to play it at, you know? For me, it's a different level. You know what I mean? I've been playing it for so long, and I get pissed if things don't go the way they should go or the progression isn't where it should be, so but
hell, we just killed Heroic Blackhand like We killed it on the Thursday before 6.2 went live, so we just got ahead of the curve. But no, I also watched Jurassic World. I got a FOF coming. It's going to involve that movie. And it's going to not have any spoilers, so don't worry about that.
Okay, good, because I haven't seen it yet.
Don't worry, it's not going to have any spoilers, but I got a FOF, and it's coming, so...
I'm calling.
Coming for you, dinosaurs. Also, I have a 3-day work week coming up, which I am really excited.
That's awesome.
I have off on Thursday and Friday, so
nice. I'm like trying to convince my office is closed.
My office is closed on Thursday and Friday, so I have 3 days, which means I've squeezed 5 days into 3 days, which is not going to be any fun. But I am looking forward to a extended weekend. It'll be fun. And that is it. So what we're going to do now is we're going to get into some news items, and then we'll do our FOFs, and then we'll do our interview with Sean, and we'll see where we're at at that point.
See where we're at.
And now I want to hear some bullshit that happened somewhere.
All right, so just a quick reminder, our June themes are up for our photo contest. You could win a $10 Amazon gift card. Because we're still in show news on top of all this. Let me see. I have a box of stuff.
Something good?
So because Ray is pretty much just like you, he's probably not going to watch the show. I'm putting together a little box of stuff I'm going to send to him. So the first up is...
You're going to send him stuff?
Yeah. Well, he doesn't have Diablo Reaper of Souls, and I want him to play with you and me.
Okay.
In more ways than one. I mean...
Okay.
So I picked up Diablo 3 Reapers of Souls for him. Best Buy was on... It was on sale for like $20, and I have like the gamers whatever thing, so I got another 20% off that, so I was like, fuck it, let's do it.
Cool.
And then,
that's really nice of you to do.
And I found this. It's a My Little Pony, like, mystery box. So, like, the Heroes of the Storm, and I know that he's a brony, so that's for him.
Yes, he'll like that.
I had to try to not...
Hunter's shaking his head, he's just like,
fuck. I had to try to not let my daughter see this, because she wanted it. And also, because we went to Chick-fil-A, we got this. It's a Birds Discovery Science thing. And we know how much he loves birds, so... I'm sending him that, and one of my multiple...
Now you know what's going to happen now, right?
What?
He's not going to open the box, and it's going to be a surprise for everyone. Like, you've shown everyone what's in the
box. Well, by the time he opens... He needs to open the box before he goes, so, I mean...
Oh, I see. Yeah.
And so, I got... Look, I'm getting rid of a keychain. I found this. It was a basketball keychain.
Okay, he likes basketball.
Mostly because I was sick of my son taking this and chucking it across the room, and...
He likes to do that.
Yeah, he really does. And then I found a Diablo stress ball. For him. And I figured he'd use this on the drive. It's a long drive. And I'm also getting him in here is it's a Catalyst Gaming Media pint glass. He never got one. So
he didn't get one, did he?
No, he didn't.
He can put Gatorade in it.
Yes, so I'm gonna send him one to help settle into
really
his
thoughtful
home. So
of
it's
you.
A little it's a little
like a care
it's kinda like a care package. So I'm sending him that. Maybe I should send him.
You gonna send him any of your pickles?
No, I'm not gonna send him any. Or maybe I should send him this owl thing. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, you should send that to him too.
You should just send him the mouse pad too. I mean, no one wants it, so just send him that mouse pad.
Send him the owl thing. now we have bacon news.
This is the king of bacon talking about bacon.
As always.
All right, so this is actually comes courtesy of Corporal Kitty on Twitter.
Corporal Kitty.
Yes, okay. It's a site that just has a list of some of the ultimate bacon treats. The article is a little old. It says it's from 2012.
Okay.
And it just kind of lists this stuff. So some of this stuff doesn't have links anymore, but you'll have to look at it. But it has baconized tiramisu, buttermilk waffle bacon cupcakes, which is actually, that's probably the one that sounds most interesting. Right after the bacon bourbon caramel popcorn.
That sounds good.
They also have a blueberry bacon cake and a maple bacon donut shot. Shot.
That reminds me.
So
I make a maple bacon drink.
Well, yeah. share. Let's go.
I like how you say it. You say it, and you have this like very sultry voice.
I am turned on right now, and I need to know more.
Are you ready to write down like the ingredients here from said bartender in front of you?
Oh, hold on. I apologize to everyone who's listening right now because I'm going to
be at BlizzCon. So
I'm going to do maple bacon shot. I apologize for my my typing on the stream.
We can put it in the show notes. If you want.
I'm doing it. All right. What is it? Here we go.
I mean, are you ready? Are you sure?
I am ready.
Change your life.
Okay.
You know that, right?
Let's do it. Right, if you just tell me it's a piece of bacon with some maple syrup, I swear to God, I'm going to reach through the internet and strangle you.
No. So what is it?
I already do that.
It's going to be served in a rocks glass, preferably over one large ice cube. You will be putting 2 ounces.
Now, hold on. Now, does it have to be an ice cube, or can you use like a whiskey stone like I have in here?
You can use that. That's fine. If you want to just throw a couple ice cubes in, but don't put too much because you don't want too much water in there.
Okay.
So you're going to do 2 ounces of Buffalo Trace bacon. And that's Buffalo Trace is like a bourbon, but there's like a Buffalo Trace, just sort of Buffalo Trace bacon, you'll find it.
Okay.
You're going to do,
I do like some Buffalo Trace bourbon, so I mean.
Yeah, that's what you'll put in there. You'll do 1/2 ounce of warm honey, it has to be warm, okay? Then you're going to do a 1/4 ounce of cherry herring.
Cherry herring?
Are
you dipping a bird in like cherry sauce? What's going on here?
If you Google it, you'll find cherry herring. It's a liqueur. You're also going to put in 3 dashes of orange bitters, and 3 dashes of Augustus regular bitters. And then what you
wait, hold on, 3 dashes of orange bitters and what? What was the next
and
one?
And 3 dashes just regular bitters.
Three
just fine.
Dashes.
Just regular bitters.
Regular bitters. All
and right. Then if you want, you can throw in like maybe a dash of soda water. Some people like that. Some people don't. And then what you do for the garnish, it's candied brown sugared bacon wrapped around a cherry on a like a stick, you know, like a
so
like
turned
a,
on right now. Like listening to you just like can you just like read ingredients? Like that's a pod Sean reads ingredients. Yeah. Like
so that's
what you don't know is I'm actually masturbating right now.
That thumping sound is him hitting the bottom
so,
of his desk.
So
amazing.
So real quick, again, it's served in like a rocks glass, a small rocks glass. 2 ounces of the bourbon, 1/4 ounce of the cherry herring, 1/2 ounce of warm honey. And then your bitters, 3 of each, orange and regular, and then your garnish to taste. A little soda water if you want.
I just did Buffalo Trace bacon, and I'm not getting anything.
You'll get it. Here, I'll find it for you.
I see.
I think the chat room's excited about this.
Food. I am. Look, I was excited too, and I just did Buffalo Trace bacon and nothing.
No, just do the Buffalo Trace bourbon. Trust me. Everything else will come together. The cherry herring is what really makes it.
Well,
just go to buffalotrace.com.
Buffalo Trace. Yes, I'm of legal drinking age.
Yes.
All right, so there I am.
So just get a bottle of the Buffalo Trace. That's all you need. Don't worry about the bacon one.
Like, no, I was excited about the bacon thing.
But he doesn't.
Okay.
Sir, we got to get on with the show, damn it. You need to get over this.
Just put bacon grease in it then. That works just as well.
Well, I know. You got to put the bacon fat. I mean, that's how you infuse some.
Mm.
And you gotta do bacon infused.
You have to make sure it's corn finished. The product, the pig is corn finished, not grass fed, because it will tear the fat off easier. So, make sure your bacon is corn fed or corn finished, technically. There you go. All
right.
I didn't even know that mattered.
Yeah, steaks are better grass fed. Beef and bacon, that kind of stuff, is better corn fed.
Hmm. All right. I'm hot. Over here. All right, let's get into some stupid people news. All right.
For somebody, we're not actually replacing Ray, but man, you really are giving him a run for his money.
You
like,
really are. Just, like, you just have brought your A game, sir.
And I've been raiding this whole time, so.
Bam! Gerbil! All right. So our stupid people news. We got to bring this up because a Pittsburgh man robbed a bank with a vibrator.
Like, well done.
Like what is going through your head when?
Sorry, the first line of that story. It's a story that's getting a lot of buzz.
But
clever.
Yeah. So yeah, this guy tried robbing a bank with a goddamn vibrator.
Hey. I mean...
Was it colored?
I don't. I don't think they give away a lot of details.
Was a BBC? We don't know.
Apparently he took the vibrator and a cell phone and made it sound like it was a bomb.
I feel like it'd be more intimidating if it were.
It's really awkward. I mean, if I was the judge, I'd just be laughing. I'm like, you are an idiot.
I don't know. I mean,
we're gonna make sure every inmate knows exactly what you did. Not only are you going into the big house, but we're gonna tell everyone that you robbed a place with a vibrator. Like, at least get a gun. Jesus.
Hey, no, it's good. You didn't kill anyone. So, I mean.
Well, I mean, if you have a gun, you're not gonna kill anyone. Just because you have a gun doesn't mean you're gonna kill anyone.
It's true.
All right. Next up, because we have to bring it up, because it is, at least I care about it, is Tom Holland is the new Spider-Man.
Yeah.
I'm going to be honest, I have no idea who Tom Holland is. I know it says that he was in The Impossible. I don't know what that was.
He looks very Peter Parker-y. Like, you know.
I don't know. Maybe.
Kind of scrawny.
Guess. I don't know what to think about this yet. Like, I've never seen him. I mean, it's good that they're getting new talent, but I mean, I don't know.
We'll see. I mean,
it's Tom Holland.
I just think it's one of those things, especially when it comes out with actors like this. And unfortunately, we are creatures of habit. So,
yeah.
Remember when everyone said Heath Ledger was going to suck as the Joker? Remember that?
I actually didn't think it was going to. I was probably one of the few people who didn't think he was going to be that bad. I know. I thought Michael Keaton was going to be bad as Batman. Which,
oh, people were like lighting it up about Heath Ledger. I remember that. People were like, what? Have you seen what Heath Ledger's been in? Like,
hey, okay. Hey, A Knight's Tale was fantastic.
I like A Knight's Tale, but.
God damn it. People.
And then it's like How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days. You know what I'm saying? Everyone knows that
movie. Was in that one too. Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Heath Ledger was in that?
Yeah.
I thought that was Matthew McConaughey.
No. Maybe you're right.
In some kind of like.
Yeah, he's in some kind of girl movie like that.
Girl movie, yeah.
Let me look.
All
right. Google.
Yeah, you keep talking. I'll keep looking.
All right, you look that up. All right, so Heather, I saw this, and we need to bring this up. Because you are such a big fan. Sonic the Hedgehog turned 24. Now's where you feel old.
Yeah, I'm old.
Sonic the Hedgehog is 24 years old.
I love him so much.
10 things I hate about you. It's 10 things I hate about you.
Oh, that one. It was 10 something. Something with 10. That was, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I feel old now. Thank you. So, great.
No.
Yep,
24.
God damn.
I thank you for this. I'll have to read through this. Some of this I know.
Yeah, I saw that, and it just had like some fun facts. Apparently, like Michael Jackson was a big fan, so that's where he got his red shoes from. Also, apparently, like people at Sega had no idea what a hedgehog really was, so they made him run fast. And he was originally going to be like an armadillo and crazy stuff, crazy things.
You can really hear the influence of Michael Jackson in Sonic 3 soundtrack. I mean, you can really like. You know, you can hear woos and what have you in, you know, that like, whatever. Anyway, you can hear the influence of Michael Jackson. I knew that one. I thought that was one of the coolest things ever because I like Michael Jackson.
But here's the thing. Imagine if the developers at Sega actually did research how shitty of a game Sonic would have been.
Probably.
It's been like the most slow moving, terrible game.
You're right. Like, it would have been bad. Yeah.
Sonic the Slowpoke Hedgehog.
He was like, we need this realistic hedgehog game. We're just going to basically just go around and poke people with his quills and maybe burrow and shit. That's about it.
Why do you got to hog the hedge? Can't share
it's
it.
A shame to see him. He's kind of gone the way of the dodo here lately. I mean,
he's like relegated to like all the Olympic games. Like he's always in like the Nintendo like
Sonic
Olympics.
Boom was pretty bad and you know. I haven't had a chance to play. There's some good Sonic Colors is supposed to be really good. I haven't played that one, you know. So apparently there's a couple good ones sprinkled in there, but
I played one on my iPad where you had to actually move the iPad. It uses like gyroscope technology to try and like let you run through a. So that was fun, and till like I let my daughter try and play it when she was like two, and then she kept running into things and got upset and threw my iPad and.
Oh.
Well, she's starting with the gamer rage, which is good. You know how you've thrown a controller before. Everyone's thrown a controller at least once in their life. If you're a true gamer, you've thrown a controller.
Yes.
So
yeah.
And I used to bend the old Nintendo controllers and the Super Nintendo. I would bend.
Yeah, there you go. That's a gamer rage.
I've never broke one, thankfully. I would have been parents.
That's good stuff. That's. But see, so her gamer rage has started really.
Oh, it bent. Oh, I'd bend it. Oh, God. Yeah.
All right.
She bent it real good.
All right, so next up we have world record pixel art in Minecraft pays homage to Blizzard games. So this was pretty cool. So world record, they made a Blizzard, I think it was like from BlizzCon. I forgot what year.
This was like 2009?
Maybe, yeah, but it has like Deathwing on it, it's got Kerrigan, and it's got Diablo on there, and it's all made out of Minecraft blocks, and it set a world record. I just thought it was pretty. It took them 23 weeks to make it, and what I really want to know is, does this person have a job, like a legitimate job, or was he getting paid just to do this? Like, I gotta know because
it could have been a labor of love. Like, he'd come home from work and work on it a couple hours. It might have been therapeutic.
I don't know. This just seems like this is something that would take a lot more time than just a couple hours here and there.
Yeah, it's like really detailed.
It is. It's really it's
like ultra detailed. Like, I feel like he's like, that's you know amazing. What? You walk into your office and you're like, oh, I got to quit. I got to make a Minecraft pixel art of BlizzCon 2009 art. I would like to be rehired after I'm done. You think you do that? I can just imagine looking at my boss's face if I said something like that to him. Be like, what?
I can't believe that's made out of pixel. Like,
I mean, I guess the question is how many hours he spent a day out of the 23 weeks actually working on it, if he even worked on it every day, which I would imagine he probably didn't.
Exactly, yeah. He could have, yeah.
So maybe like 4 or 5 hours a day, right? So let's just say that he did it. Let's do some math, guys. I like math. You like math? I do.
Math! So
he did it four. Let's say he took 1 day off a week. He's a regular guy. Maybe he wanted to go to Taco Bell or Pizza Hut and have a night out with the boys. So let's say he did it 4 hours a day.
Did he have a gordita or did he go with like nachos Bel Grande?
Oh, that's probably a really good question. I would imagine he probably had like some kind of combo of the two or three regular tacos and then what the hell is the thing I always get? Cheesy gordita crunch.
Oh, that's my jam. Dude, I ate one of those today. No joke.
Okay, so let's just say he worked on it 6 days a week, 4 hours a day, times 23 weeks is 522 hours. And then we'll divide that by 24, which is how many hours in a day. So it was actually 23 full days if you worked on it 4 hours a day, 6 days a week for 23 weeks. So, wow, 20 comes up a lot there.
Maybe that's the meaning of life. Maybe Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy got it wrong.
Yeah, 42. Not it. It's not it, guys. How to lose a guy in 10 days.
All right, and since Zia, you have been a little bit more into Diablo lately, and since we're sending Ray Diablo key, I want to bring this up. Diablo patch 2.3 changes. They're adding more difficulties. They're bringing in the cube.
Yeah.
Like, so they're bringing back the Herodric cube, but I don't think they're calling it the Herodric cube.
No, it's Kanani's cube. It's the original form of it. Back when it was ultra powerful.
So. I remember just doing weird shit with the Herodric cube and shit back in Diablo 2 days.
You mean duping? Is that what you were doing? Were you duping? You were duping, weren't you?
I was making rune words. God damn it. Actually, I was also using it for extra storage space because.
Well, I was duping. That's what I was doing. All
right. Well, I was using it for extra storage space.
That sounds really cool, I think.
And also, they're making some crafting changes. They're going to make it a little bit easier to craft stuff and make it worth your while. So, I really need to get my seasonal character leveled up.
I can power level you if you want. Take me about an hour.
I'm all
70.
But look, he comes on the show. He's offering to power level me. What are you doing with your life, Zia? What are you doing? Like, I'm kicking Ray off the show. Sean's on
fire. It sounds like you're trying to replace me, too.
Might as well. No one else is offering to power level me. God damn it.
Yeah, it took me like about. I got my mage. I got my wizard on Diablo 3. They call them wizards. I got him power leveled up about an hour and a half, and I got him like 4-piece set. You know, whatever. So I mean, it doesn't take very long because like I don't like. This is the thing. I don't know about you guys. I like the game. I don't like getting to the end game. You know what I mean?
See, like, for me, I like only the end game.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. I only like the end game. Like, I only like trying to find gear. Like, I've played the story. I don't care anymore. I just want to get to the end, you know? So I'll make my buddies power level me because I won't do it. Yeah. But then I'll power level friends of mine because I know, I understand.
It's like a trade off. Like,
sucks. Yeah.
I love the grind for gear. I hate grinding the levels up.
Which is kind of ironic, right? Because it's the exact same thing in a sense. Pretty and much. If anything, what you're doing for gear is actually more boring than the actual storyline.
I think the leveling is the you know, the explosion you get every time.
I tricked my girlfriend into leveling a crusader for me once.
Nice work.
It was awesome. And then I just geared it. I would gear it when she wasn't around to see if she noticed the gear was better. And she actually did.
Did she notice it? All right.
Yeah, she's like, I found this really awesome, you know, legendary. She goes, but then I realized that there was, for some reason, there was already one already better out there.
You're like, yes. Like,
See, when I'm leveling and I'm getting like legendaries, I'm like, I'm going to just disenchant this thing in like a couple levels anyway.
Yeah. I really wish they'd bring back rune words. I really wish they'd bring back like that old stock.
I liked rune words.
I loved rune words. Actually, it was funny when Diablo 3, I think with the first 6 months it was out, I sent a tweet to Diablo, like the official Diablo Twitter, and I said, hey, you know what makes Diablo 3 100 times better? I said, turning off the music and listening to Diablo 2 music.
Oh.
It actually makes Diablo 3 way better, just in case you're wondering.
I've never done that.
It's awesome. Because it's the nostalgia while playing an updated version of the game.
Of it, so. Yeah.
Diablo 2, I love playing as a druid.
Yeah, I always
into wolf form.
You always got to make your wizard first for your magic find. And then you play. You know, then you just do whatever from there.
Oh, what I did was in Diablo 2, I had my Amazon. I had a Spiridon.
Oh, dude, Spiridon, sick. And you do you're just constantly just spamming.
It was ridiculous because all the lightning damage. Like I used to just like run Pindleskin over and over again. I got all the legendaries.
If I were to play Diablo 2 now, I'd have to make my magic find Sork, and then I'd have to make my Zealotin for Uber Diablos and stuff. So after I make my Zealotin, then it's just whatever. I make whatever because then I'm like, I can do anything I want in this game now. Between the magic find Sork, doing meph runs, and the Zealotin, whatever, you know.
All right, and lastly, because 6.2 has been covered forever, and if you want like real 6.2 news, go listen to the Edge podcast. They'll have some good feedback. But
it's actually really true.
It really is.
They're way better like, than we are.
Look. I've done a whole lot of dailies. I've started rating. I know what's going on, but I don't want to bore you with a casual's perspective. Go get the experts. But what's interesting is Forbes put out an article saying, providing 7 ways that World of Warcraft builds better leaders. And you're going to have to disregard a lot of what Sean said earlier about Madicus. No, it was interesting. They had someone who works at like a big consulting firm, Deloitte, like basically saying that they would rather hire a high-level World of Warcraft player than an MBA from Harvard.
Do you know that there was a guy that was a CEO of a very, very large firm, financial firm, quit his job, played World of Warcraft for a year, came back, and created Glassdoor.com. Hmm. And he was like a hardcore raider. Like, nice. Big time, quit his job, didn't care about anything else. And that's exactly what he said, too. He's like, anyone like that puts down that they were like a raid leader or that kind of thing, they actually take that very seriously. Because if they have played the game, they understand like it's not an easy thing to do.
Yeah, but they basically said that raiding was like a training ground for modern business leaders, and like one of the big things was like the fact that you're working with virtual teams and seamless collaboration. And it's true. Like my team is all not sure. I'm not with my team all the time. Like I am in different locations for my company, so sometimes I have to manage them and direct them. While like over the phone, like I'll be driving from one location to another and say, hey, I need you to get on. And it's true, the virtual team, like I never thought about it that way, but it has helped. I think, in that. And they also said digital communication channels. Says that, like, because people use, like, voice over IP, they find different ways to communicate. And my team, we use Slack at work for my team, so we can seamlessly collaborate when we're not on the company network. Make sure that we're all, like, working together if we need help or whatnot. They also said creating a successful team. You know, right now I go through and I'm recruiting and I'm looking at people, like, and I'm just saying, like, and I'm asking them almost like a lot of the questions I usually ask potential members of our guild. Like, you know, how do you deal with people who don't have the same viewpoints as you? How do you handle change that you don't necessarily agree with? Like, I ask people who I'm hiring these things, and I realize I ask the same questions of people that that are joining my guild and my real life team. Motivating volunteers. So this part I really don't. None of my team is volunteers. So this is the one I kind of don't necessarily agree with. So I mean, obviously in game, yes, you have to motivate people who are, look, this is their leisure time. But at work, look, your motivation is, if you don't do a good job, you're gonna get fired. You're not gonna get a bonus. You're not gonna get a raise. Like, so I mean, motivation at work is a little easier.
It's easier, but like you definitely have days where you're like, ugh, I've got to get myself going. Like, ugh, like everyone has those days. And so having someone who's like able to just like get you out of that funk, I think. I mean, is that fair to say?
I guess, but I mean, you know, like I said, it's just different because at work, like, you're still collecting that paycheck. You want to, I mean, we at work, we have a very much something where, look, you perform well, like, you know, we're going to mark you up higher. If you don't perform well, you're going to mark lower. So I mean, everyone has their ups and down weeks. And when I talk with my team members, I mean, I talk about that. I'm like, you know, I think you had a down week this time, and you know what's going on. And so, I mean, like, I talk to them, but
and then you help motivate them to do better.
I mean, the thing is, most of my team honestly is motivated by money and their career. So I mean,
right? Okay, I'm not gonna argue this with you.
No. I mean, my team is just so there's nothing I could promise our raid team. I mean, you've seen we have a very casual raid team. There's nothing I can say like, hey, you know, if you do better, you know, we're going to get a bonus at the end of this raid tier.
I think this applies more to high-end raiding, truth be told.
Probably.
Just think about it. Like, I mean, like, back when I was pushing for, like U.S., like, top 25, like, I would take time off from work. I would say, okay, I'm taking 3 weeks off from my job, my real-life job. I don't want to talk to anyone. I'm not going to hang out with you. Don't call me. Leave me alone. I'm literally going to stock my fridge full of food. And I will play 20 hours a day, every day, for 3 weeks until I get this down. And that's, I think, what they're talking about with motivating, because it's like, what am I getting out of this? I'm not getting anything. Maybe some really, really bad eyesight and bad posture. But other than that, like, and diabetes, like I told you I was going to have. But I mean, I'm not getting paid for this unless I'm on Method or Paragon or, you know, I'm sponsored, which I'm not. And even those guys get a heads up because they're the teams that Blizzard will send the encounters to before they're even released. Mm-hmm. Just say, hey, tune these for us. What do you guys think? So you wonder why it's like, oh, they're so good. They're the best in the world. It's like, no, they've had practice on this already. You know what I mean? So, but I can tell you from someone who's rated like high, super high end, like I don't know how any way to explain this to you, but if you know what it's like to raid, imagine raiding in an environment where when you wipe, you have less than, depending on the run back, 20 seconds to run back, get ready, and pull again. And while you have that run back, you aren't like bullshitting. You're talking about who could be doing better. You're screaming at someone because their hot's not high enough. You're screaming at somebody because they didn't get it out of the shit fast enough. Like, it's like, okay, hurry up, yell, scream, get it ready, pull, go, wipe, 20 seconds, go. And then you'll get maybe 2 minutes for a bathroom break every 6 to 8 hours. You know what I mean? Like, that's
our rating environment is much different than that.
Yeah, that's so intense.
Now imagine trying to get people motivated to do that for 3 weeks straight.
I think one time we were talking about how someone's balls were stuck to their leg because it was so hot and their air conditioner was broken.
Yeah. I mean, that sounds about right.
I think that like people in those kind of environments are just, that's like a friendly casual, like you know, Friday night game night at someone's house. You know what I mean? Like, and that's cool too. You know what I mean? Like that's the whole reason why this game is awesome, is because it brings people together like that. It's just, you know, like I can tell you from a high end standpoint, it's not fun to raid like that. I will tell you, I'll be the first one to tell you that. It sucks. It's stressful. You're constantly going to get called out. You're worried. You're going to be the worst one. Like, it's a lot of work. And to stay motivated like that, it's more of a personal goal. And no one really tells you. Like, no one's like, okay, Sean, we're going to get it this time. Like, you know, heads up. No, they're like, we better down this fucking thing or else we're not going to go to sleep until we do. So it's like, all right. Guess we're going to kill it then.
Yeah.
So I guess that's how I look at it anyways. Like, when I'm reading all these over, that's the first thing that popped into my head anyways. So, but yeah. I mean.
The next thing they said is taking risk and continuous improvement. So I think that definitely applies. So I know at my work, I tell my team, like, they'll come to me and say, like, you know, we could do it this way or we could do it this way. I'm like, well, which way is better? Like, well, this one is, like, we know what we're doing here. This one, it could pay off for us, but it could backfire. I'm like, go with that one. They're like, but wouldn't that be bad if it? I'm like, well, if it backfires, well, at least we know what's going to happen then. Like, gotta try it. So, I mean, and that's kind of like, at least from my perspective, right? Like, we'll try different things. We'll move things around. We'll say, all right, well, let's send these people in here. Let's add another healer. Let's take away a healer. Can we one tank this? Like, I mean, we'll try different things, and we're not hardcore, but we'll still try things, and we're like, the worst that happens for us is like, didn't work. We'll try something else.
But I think that takes a special group of people too. I mean, not everyone can do that. You know, that's a whole different player base. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That for me, I couldn't do that. I would be like diving into logs mid raid, being like, so and so needs, you need to bench this person. You need to bring someone in for this fight because that's a high movement. You know, you can't have anyone that has to like paladins or whatever. Like, you need someone that can run and heal, or, you know, we don't have cast and move anymore. So, you know, that's screwed. We need more melee. Actually, Hellfire Citadel is actually very melee friendly, believe it or not. So,
yeah,
melee.
I've seen that so far. But then the next one is like poison and pressure. Like, so yeah, I mean, this is probably the
Please
one.
Please do
that
not I'm, tell me that you're. Go
no,
ahead.
No, this is probably the one that I'm worst at. Because okay, when things kind of get a little chaotic in game, like, I'll be just like, fuck it. Someone else died. It's done. We're done. It's over. Let's wipe it. But like at work, like when shit's hitting the fan, like I have to be this. Because my team's like, what do we do? I was like, okay, well, all right. This is who you need to contact. This person is what I need you to do. Like game / raid leader me versus at work me is very different for this number six, poison and pressure. And it's probably because I don't take it as seriously as a high end raider would.
Well, it depends on what role you play. What role do you play in your guild?
Usually I'm co-raid leader and main tank.
So you're a tank? That's why. It's hard to do that and raid lead at the same time.
It really is. There's
It is. You need to be a healer.
I used to be like our main raid leader when back in Vanilla and Burning Crusade. And
Zero, you just cannot relinquish control is the problem.
No, well, I can't. Jim is pretty much our raid leader right now. He's been raid leading us because he's a mage. He's at range because and he can
and
see
he
things.
Is, and he is very That's... poised under pressure.
But to Sean's point, you really can't raid lead main tank because you're it's up hard. In the crotch of the boss and you can't see everything that's going on.
It is hard. Yeah, I totally agree. I mean, I can tell you that like depending on, we have two different raid leaders, the GM and the assistant GM, and then one of our main tanks will call stuff out if it's a more of a tank important switch or whatever. But being at range definitely helps. Like, they'll switch whoever raid calls depending on what we bring in specifically for that fight, whether it's heals or if it's range DPS, like Hunter. Like, our GM is a Hunter right now, so he helps a lot too because he can see a lot more of what's going on. It does make a difference. It really does.
So. Yeah, so, like, one of the things that is bad is, like, when, like, things have been getting chaotic with Kilrog, like, I'll find myself panning my screen around and looking at, like, is there a blob coming? What's going on? And then next thing I know, I'm missing the fact that I should be, like, death gripping one of the adds away from the pool and shit gets out of control.
Yeah.
So. So the last one here is visibility and accountability. And this is one that, even though we're casual, is very true. It's all about showing, like, you know, how to see how everyone's contributing to success. And we use, obviously, Ask Mr. Robot logs for that.
Those are awesome, by the way.
I agree. They are unbelievable. We use the infographics. We look at that. And even at work, I create infographics and charts and graphs based on how well our team is performing. You know, did we do better or worse over last quarter?
I'm sorry. Was this an entire segment that you dedicated to stroking your own dick about how well you are at work compared to how well you do in the game?
Wow. No, I'm just...
Is that what this was?
This is a conversation.
And every single thing you've been like, well, I do that at work. And I do that at work. Like...
This is a big applause for Seraph's dick.
Is this what this is?
What I'm trying to get to is a lot of this stuff that we've done in game, like, I have actually taken and I've actually applied it to work. Like, so a lot of this is true in my case. Like, when I used to do my job, like, I never started making graphs and charts and tracking and creating, like, true dashboards of how progress is being made before. No, and so, like, we started using, like, logs and graphical representation, even from Warcraft logs, and as we advanced, like, World of Logs, and, like, I started taking, like, some of those things and saying, like, you know, how can I apply? I feel like being a raider has helped me in my job.
That sounds a lot better. Like, that makes more sense to me.
I want to reach through the internet and just slap the shit out of you.
I know you do. I'm somewhat joking with you, but I knew that was going to piss you off. I was like, because you're like, yeah, well, I do that at work all the time. I motivate my team all the time. Like,
well, I have, but no, but a lot of this stuff, like, going back to, like, the motivation, like, I have to do that because my boss is judging me on based on how well I do that. And that directly impacts how much money I make. Mm-hmm. Pure and simple. Like, if I'm not motivating my team, my boss calls me out on that, gives me a lower grade, and guess what? I don't get as high of a raise. So, I mean, but that goes back to the incentive. I have more incentive to do some of this stuff at work than I do when I'm raiding. But I picked up a lot of this stuff from raiding and applied it to my job. And I think that a lot of the stuff that we've done throughout the years as raiders has helped me in my job dealing with, you know, people who may not agree with you, people who, you know, challenge the status quo, like how to measure people. Like, it's Warcraft raiding has helped me.
So Joe Brewer in the channel asks, would you put MMO experience on a resume? Sean says yes, he would.
Yeah, fuck yes, I would. And if someone asked me about it, I'd be like, okay, well, what do you want to know specifically? They'd be like, well, why would you put a game, you know, some kind of game experience on a resume? And I'd say, well, it shows how much I'm dedicated to something, how hardworking I am, how if I get my mind right and then I accomplish the goals, I see things through. I don't half-ass my work. I always strive to be the best. I'm a perfectionist. You know what I mean? Like, there's ways to really center your good qualities by using something you're very passionate about. And that's the thing that a lot of people screw up on, especially on interviews, is that, and even with podcasts and anything else in life, like, your passion is the thing that shows through. Passion is something you can't fake. And if you're really excited.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, I think he froze.
Yep, Sean just froze. But I think what he's saying, I mean, so for me, as someone who's like, I don't just put on your resume that you play games. Don't just say, oh, I play games. You know, you want to say, like, you know, I have, you know, MMO experience or MMO leadership experience. You want to kind of highlight it in some way. And honestly, I don't know the best way to put that on a resume.
I wouldn't know either. I put Catalyst, like, that. The fact that we do the event in November, I've added that to my resume.
Like, you could probably put, like, high level, like, ability to lead virtual teams.
Yeah.
You could probably do something like that. So, I mean, I think there is... all right, so Sean says he's still there, but he's not in Skype. So once he comes back, we will get this him back up and running. But I think that... there is a way to do it without like coming out, because there are going to be some companies where you're going to have like some of those people who are more traditional, who are going to see MMO and they're going to be like, what's that? Or so don't put out gaming. I would definitely like highlight what it is that you're doing in gaming. Like I said, leading virtual teams, working well in group, you know, good teamwork. There's things there that I feel that are good. And now, if you are applying to obviously a gaming company or even more of a internet startup or even internet like a Google or whatnot, I would definitely put MMO experience. Like if you're, especially if you're a high end rater, I'd put MMO high end rating experience. And especially if you were a leader of that team, like I put that somewhere on your skills.
See, I don't know. Like for me, I guess I couldn't disagree more because
And he froze again.
He froze again.
He disagreed. See,
he disagreed. But see, me and Sean are coming after you today, buddy.
That's fine.
I hate this. Damn Skype.
There he is.
But like, I don't know if I'm actually going to stay on here long enough to actually make a valid point or not. But what I was saying was, people that grew up playing video games are now in positions of authority. They are taking over now. They're more familiar like with what's going on. And gaming isn't such a taboo thing to talk about anymore. This isn't like a, oh, you play Super Mario Brothers? Is that the thing where you have to shoot the thing in the sky? Like, people are more accepting of gaming and gaming culture. And they understand that gaming makes more money than movies, music, and TV combined. It makes more money than the NFL. Okay? It just does. And anyone that doesn't think that it does doesn't know what they're talking about. Because if you put on an esports production where League of Legends had a $1.6 million purse, you know how much it cost them to put that production on? Less than like $15,000.
I think... I agree with you, but at the same time, as someone who hires someone, like, I don't want to just say, oh, he plays games. I want to say, how is your game playing experience going to better yourself as an employee? I want that to be highlighted in some way.
Well, that's where it would be, but that's where the conversation starts. Because, I mean, I did the same thing. I hired people for years, and that's one of the things I would try to find about them. What's your passion? What do you love to do? Because I would ask, the very first interview question I would ask people is, I would say, what's your next job after this? Where do you want to apply after you leave here? And people would always throw, it was such a weird question for most people because they were really nervous. Like, why the hell would I talk about another company when I'm trying to get in with you? And I'm like, the reason why I'm asking you this is because I want to know what I can teach you and what I can help you with to make you grow as a person so I can help you lead you to that position that you ultimately want to be at. So, and that's where you start getting into like, oh, this is what I love to do. And this is actually what my passion is. And then you can see that spark in their eyes. And then you know how to manage and really isolate their skills. But if you're just like, oh, question number one, are you a good fit for this position? Question number two, do you know the difference between provolone and mozzarella cheese?
Whoa,
you
know, hold on. I do know the difference between them. But anyway, yeah, <that's>... right.
You know, it's just for me, I just think that, you know, like I said, gaming is a worldwide thing now. Everyone and their grandmother knows what gaming is, even if it's as small, something small as games on your iPad or your iPhone or Candy Crush or whatever. It's different nowadays, and it's, I don't think it's a bad thing to almost like say hide who you really are and be ashamed of it.
No, I don't think you need to hide. And like, so for my my boss, he is a gamer. And me and him, we talk about gaming. I mean, he has a Mortal Kombat 2 arcade machine in the basement of his house.
What? Word? Yeah. That sounds awesome.
Yeah, he's awesome. But at the same time, I know plenty of hiring managers at my company who are not gamers. Now, there's another director I know who is huge in EverQuest. I know that for a fact because I've talked to him about it. I'm like, I don't know how you did it. Like, apparently, yeah. Like gold weighted you down. I'm like, that sounds ridiculous to me. But
right.
But like, I know a lot of hiring managers who are not gamers, or they are truly old school, but I also know a few that are, or I know up and coming ones, like you said. But I was just telling like Joe B is I want to make sure, if it, put it on your resume, but you got to phrase it in a certain way that shows the value. Don't just say that I like to play video games.
Well, right.
Because I play MMOs. Like I don't, that I'm like, okay, that doesn't.
Well, right,
but if you tell me like you were a high end World of Warcraft raider, I'm like, okay, talk to me about that. How was it working with a virtual team? You know, that I can understand.
usually that's the place that you put it down with like other and like other things or skills or hobbies or interests that you would, you know, additional information. That's what I'm saying. Like,
yeah.
It's not gonna be something you're gonna highlight and be like, you know, I didn't work for 4 years because I dedicated my life to a game, eat, breathe, and sleep it. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
It's one of those things where you can say, hey, this is something additional I did on top of working hard and progressing in my career field that also furthered my skill set in these ways, you know? And I think that a lot of people, especially, you know, I can tell you for me, the reason why I feel like, you know, I'm so illiterate is because I played a lot of RPGs growing up. It forced me to read, and that helped me become a smarter person overall because I learned to pick up on context clues. I learned to figure things out on my own and be creative and read a lot. So I don't know. I mean, those things really shaped who I am today, and it's just something that I'm very proud of, you know. So, but I totally agree with you in that. Don't be like, I play World of Warcraft. They'd be like, okay, great. Yeah. You know, like I eat chili for breakfast. Like no one gives a shit. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like,
hey, wait a minute, you eat chili for breakfast?
Sometimes. That's nice. I'm an adult. I do what I want.
Good for you.
Whatever, man. Whatever. I do what I want.
All right, think about whatever we want. Let's get into some thoughts here.
Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. You're cool. And fuck you. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you, Saddam Hussein of Iraq.
I feel like I'm gonna show up on your FOSS now.
No, I've already said my piece about you.
I wasn't actually trying to. It came out meaner than I meant. Sorry.
So Sean, we usually let our guests kind of come up last. So I'm gonna start with Zia. What about you? Let's start with you. Ladies first.
Thanks. Look at you. You are so unhappy with me right now.
So unhappy with you.
You're so mad at me right now. Your fucking face when I said that, you were like...
You know what's funny? Because as soon as you said it, this is what I was thinking right here.
Now we're going to get sued for playing bad boys.
Shit on now.
That's all he needed. That's all he needed.
Now there's a lawsuit coming.
Yeah, right. Seriously. That was not the real theme, by the way. That was something I was memeing out of my mouth.
Okay.
You know what? I am going to say, somebody in the chat room actually just pointed out, and I'm going to agree with them. So Loki says, props to Ray for moving up in the world. I'm going to have to second that. I am really proud of our co-host, and we,
he's all grown up.
He's all grown up. We always sort of worried about, you know, his... We know how bright he is. He sort of has this persona.
I'm going to have to take that out. We don't want him to ever hear that we think he's bright.
No, he's actually quite dumb.
He's a big dummy.
And he's kind of a dumbass. No, we'll never say this again. We'll say this. I was having a moment and it was opposite day. No, he really is a bright guy. And you always have, it's always like the kid in the class who's like, the class clown, right? And they're always usually one of the smartest people in the room. And he really is a smart guy. And I think he just deserves a lot of good things to come his way. And I'm glad that he's going out on this adventure. I'm excited for him. And I hope it creates a lot of opportunity for him because he deserves it. So, yeah, props to Ray. Loki, thank you. That was a really good one. I was like, oh, you know, I've been thinking about him a lot. So...
Yeah, so I mean, we're just gonna tag on Logan. So Logan just said props to Ray for moving up in the world. So,
yeah.
All right. So people have been saying they've been wanting to hear what my Jurassic Park or Jurassic World FOF was. So.
I do.
All right. So Jurassic World. There's no spoilers in this. No spoilers. It's spoiler free. Okay. I'm gonna talk about like just a major plot point that you've seen in the trailers. I'm going to say, fuck off to Jurassic World for a giant, glaring story gap. So there's two kids that go to the park. Their aunt runs said park. They get VIP bracelets. They are told that these VIP bracelets allow them to never wait in line for a single ride. What happens? They're waiting in fucking line! They're waiting in line. You actually watch them standing in line for a ride. Why have VIP bracelets if you have to? God damn it, Universal. Yes,
maybe it's like a fast pass.
It's fucking bullshit is what...
That's a problem with continuity. That's a problem.
They are literally standing in line with the rabble. They are literally standing in line with the rest of the rabble. There is no separate line. There is only one line with the rabble. They are in it. They are not getting to the front of the line. It's bullshit. It's absolute fucking bullshit. All right? And the movie's made by Universal. And I'm going to have to talk with Jim, who works for Universal. He raids with us. And I'm going to have to talk to him.
I'm sure because, he had a lot to do with the movie.
Because if this is any indication of how Universal runs their fast pass system, you know, I don't want any part of it. I don't want any part of this bullshit. Fucking clown shoes. All right? Fuck! All right, good.
Feel better?
Yeah, I feel better. Good. All right, Sean, what about you?
The bracelets are cool, though, just for the record. Let me think. Well, I can't go into too much detail for, like, obvious reasons of personal privacy and legal reasons. But where I work had an outbreak of the norovirus before I went on vacation. So that effectively killed our business for a little while. So people who patrons out there, you sons of bitches who like to use the fucking bathroom and not wash your hands, you're a piece of shit. I just wanted you to know that. So
that's affected you.
Yeah, it was pretty terrible. So that was fun.
That's terrible.
Yep.
That happened.
It was pretty awful. Now we're like the black sheep of the community, you know, which is actually terrible because people have actually come out and like really reputable, like journalists and stuff have like written all these articles saying like how everything was, you know, great. The health department was like, nah, everything's fine. Like they're like in terms of like how it was handled and, you know, once it was gone. You know what I mean? Like, it's all good. You know what I mean? Now, like it's shit happens sometimes, you know, whatever. But everyone's still like, you know, it's a perception thing. So if I find out the person who caused this type of thing to happen, because obviously it was an employee, so it's like the cleanest friggin' place I've ever worked in my life, then I will castrate you. So.
What if they're a woman?
Then I will find a way to castrate her.
Okay.
This don't hurt the boobs. Thanks, my boobies hurt.
they okay. Well, there you go. So. All right. Ta-da.
All right, so that all being said, we got a call from Rigor Morty. So let me play that.
Great. Hello, Surfist, Rapist, and Zia. Yep, this is my weekly fuck off firstly to, I don't know whether I've got allergies now that I'm getting old, I guess, but I get this happen more since I gave up smoking like 7, 8 years now. I've got this kind of blocked nose effect. Keeps coming and going. I think it's allergies, but the allergy shit you take doesn't really have much of an effect. So I got some new spray shit tonight, which might work, which might help a little bit. Sudafed's good, but it's expensive. Keeps you awake because it's a speed derivative, but it's highly effective in that sense. Fucking idiot. I've been playing a lot of WoW lately, but it's all been kind of on alts. I started doing like an Iron Man challenge. And he's level 15 now, and he's a lot of fun. Undead Priest, slow going though. It's just, when all you've got is Shadow Weird Pain and Smite, it just takes a long time to burn shit down. And I nearly died recently, because I got dropped in front of a fucking angry worgen in an undead starting area, quest bug, and I couldn't bubble for like 3 seconds. Shit, that's kind of cool. Session with my mistress this past week, which is a lot of fun. Can't get away, fucking, sorry. It was awesome. It's always a really big stress reliever. Busy work week. There's somebody at work. You're not really meant to whinge about work, but there's a person at work that said on, because my boss was around last week on Wednesday, and I got in, I checked with downstairs because they do some of my work for me to help me kind of get through shit. And I said, I'll get you some more work in about 5 or 10 minutes when I get a second. Have you got enough files or whatever to go on with? She's like, oh, yeah. We've got at least a couple here, so that should be okay. I go upstairs, put the fucking kettle on, and I'm like, all right, yeah, I'm going to get settled down. I'll look at some stuff. I'll get the box out because I'm going to go through anyway. And through it, right? So I'm fucking start doing that, and I get a phone call from my boss downstairs. She says, have you got any files? She said, this person says they haven't got any. I'm like, you motherfucking throw me under the bus, cunt. You know, I just asked, you stupid. And she's one of those people that's like, I've got no files, so I can't do it, so... Part of your job, this is something you're helping me out with. I am 8 months behind in backlog of shit to deal with, so any help I get is a bonus, so she can fucking fuck off big time. And people that can't answer the fucking phone at work, somebody else at Wind's Network, and they can't answer the phone, they kind of get the name wrong, or like, oh, I'm sorry, can I take your telephone and bring it out? They just gave it to you, in normal speaking speed. Fuck off that shit. Props to fucking, I went to the, I had to go to the train station. Here it is on Saturday night at 10:45, which is the best time to go to the fucking train station, because it's just a meat market. There's tits and ass everywhere. People are drunk, falling over each other, fucking puking up on pavement. That's an adventure in itself. So, if you've got nothing better to do, you know, I don't fancy an amusement, go to the train station or bus station at fucking this time of night. Anyway, guys, you guys are awesome. I'll catch you all later.
Rigamote.
Rigamote.
That was one long monologue.
Yeah, so so everyone's just like, Rigamote needs to breathe. So I just want to let everyone know that, like, I trimmed this down because there was, like, actually long pauses while he was, like, turning. You heard him turning or speeding up or slowing down. I just, like, trimmed some of that out. So he did take breaths in between all that. I just kind of cut that out when he sent it in because there was, like, long spaces.
But not he was like...
Just like edit it down so he says a lot of funny shit.
I mean, trust me, it's something that I've always thought about. Like, I've done that before, like a long time ago with Tazia and Ray, where I just cut stuff out and
splice it together. There's nothing better when you're just looking at someone and you're like, fuck it right in the pussy. You know what I'm saying?
I'm pretty sure he usually says cunt. It always makes you laugh when he says cunt. I think it's funny when he says twat. And then I want to say this time around, it sounded like he said stupid slut, which is funny to me. So
I love it.
But it sounds like he said he had his stock stolen. He had his, you know, this
goddamn hobos stealing his socks. All right, let's see. Joe B says in the chat, props to legalization of same-sex marriage. Foff to my Twitter and Facebook page, turning into a colorblind test.
Yeah, that same-sex.
Oh, go ahead. Go ahead. I just thought of something real quick, but I go.
So that was something the same-sex legalization. That my Facebook page, holy shit, somebody would post and be like, yay, da, da, da. And like every single, every single post, there was always people arguing. Like
position on Facebook. You can't post political stuff.
You just can't. She was getting real. Sorry, well, go ahead, Sarah.
I just want to let everyone know, everyone who on Facebook who ran their profile picture through that little rainbow filter and then changed it, and it's probably going to be on Twitter too, but these social media companies are selling that data to the political campaigns to give them demographics of how many people are actually pro this change and who are not, or neutral. They're pulling that data and selling it. Like there was an article written about Facebook using that. I have to dig it up, but just let you all know, like, when you do change, like, profile pictures, when you say, like, that information is being data mined.
That's crazy.
Like, my company, we ask social media sites to data mine certain pieces of information for us based upon our industry, and we use that to help us with marketing. So, if you say, oh, well, my profile is private, doesn't matter. We don't want your name. That's not the information we get. We just want to know how many men are pro this or how many women are anti that. And if we can get state information or in country information, we'll take it too. We don't need your name. We don't need your address. We don't need to know your friends.
God, that's scary, isn't it?
It's just like on the iPhone where they record every place that you go and for how long you've been there. Have you seen that setting in your iPhone?
What is it?
Like it's an iPhone setting that tracks you through GPS. So it'll tell me every time I've been to work and what time I got there and what time I left, and it'll log it. So like even though I've never put in like work, it will know it's work for me because I've visited.
Because it's where you're at.
Right. So it'll know exactly. And then what it will do is like, it knows like what you're around and where you go, and then it'll know how to market you and give you ads on like Facebook and all these things, like, because it will center towards what you do and where you go. It's and you can't shut it off unless you shut off your GPS. And if you shut off your GPS, your basically your phone doesn't work. So if you shut off, you have to shut off like, your Wi-Fi, your GPS, like all your location services. It's crazy.
But yeah, so I mean, so I just want just I just wanted to throw that out there. Just be aware of what's happening on social media. Like
that shit's real.
Let's see. And then Adams also says, major props to Edwin from ISN Radio for sitting down with me for almost 2 hours today, chilling in a chat one-on-one with a personality I have followed for over a decade was awesome. That does sound pretty cool.
Yeah, that's cool.
I don't know what ISN Radio is, but it sounds cool. Yeah. And you want to take Toasties?
Sure, I can take Toasties. Toasties says, fop to the massive fire in my neighbor's backyard that took out a good chunk of my fence. Damn, adrenaline kept me up until 9 in the morning yesterday. Holy shit. I hope everything is okay. Sorry about your fence.
Yeah, that's kind of suck. But, in the meantime, not to make light of your fence.
Yeah.
Let's get into our interview with Sean.
Mm-hmm. What the hell's wrong with you?
Does my ass look weird?
What is your profession?
Where's my money?
What, do you think I'm some kind of pervert or something?
Am I missing a tooth?
That name sounds like royalty. Are you royalty?
Wow, what does that mean?
Do you suck dick?
What's not to love?
I'm your excuse!
Are you off your fucking meds or something?
Are you shook up? Are you nervous?
All right, so Sean, we're going to do just some quick fire questions. Just answer first thing that comes to your head. Do you want to just alternate everyone? All right.
Yes.
You want to go first? You want me to go first?
I'll go first.
Okay.
Okay. All right.
Vagina. Oh, wait. Have we started? Yeah.
All right. Favorite pizza topping?
Pepperoni.
Thank you.
Guilty pleasure mobile game?
Temple Run.
What color would your lightsaber be?
White.
Most underrated comic book superhero?
Ant-Man. Because it's for the movie. It's appropriate.
Favorite TV show no longer on?
24.
Have you watched The Goonies? And if so, do you feel it still holds up?
Yes and yes.
Oh, sorry. Movie you own but might be ashamed to tell people.
Oh, God.
Now you're going to tell everyone.
I don't know. I don't really have anything that's like that, I guess. Maybe The Blair Witch Project? That's a pretty terrible movie.
She's like, I'm so scared right now. And the snot's coming out of her nose. That's fantastic.
It's so bad, you know? It's not even good.
Fictional universe you would want to live in.
You took my question.
Wait, no, that was...
Oh, was it? Oh, just kidding. Obviously, pregnancy brain.
Obviously, I have to say the World of Warcraft universe, obviously. So. Yeah.
If you were a raid boss, what would your ultimate ability be or do?
It would probably be...
I know why you asked that.
I don't know. Like, I don't know. There's like so many things going through my head. I'd probably want to do some kind of like devastate move, like warriors have, where it reduces armor from everyone in the raid by like 40%. So they have to use a lot more strategy to down the boss. So it's a lot harder when everyone's taking more damage.
You know, way back when we had the training dummies on the show, we asked Zia what her ultimate ability would be. And she said that she would queef and knock everyone off the ledge.
Wow.
And then she immediately followed up by like, I didn't say that. I didn't mean that.
But it was one of those things where I was like, You think it and it tickles you, you know, because it's so funny, but it's so like bizarre that you're like, I'm not gonna say that. That's really just revolting. And the more I thought about it, the more I was like, that's really fucking funny. I think I'm just gonna say it and see what happens.
It's funny because there's a lot of like wind mechanics over the past couple expansions too, so that actually is really appropriate that you would say that. You could call it the heavy gust.
All right. What superpower would you want and why?
To fly, because who the fuck would want to fly?
All right.
Everyone says invisible. It's always creepy. Who the fuck wants to be invisible? It's weird. I want to fly.
See, I like the whole telekinesis thing, like Jean Greyhead, because then you can make yourself fly, but then you could also do like mind tricks and.
Yeah, I don't want to go crazy. I just want to be able to like fly.
I'll go crazy. Yeah. Fuck it. Why not? All right. What do you think? What do you think, Zia? Do you think we have time for a quick Mad Libs here?
How long have we been going?
Maybe about like a little bit over an hour after we got the video thing straightened up.
An hour?
Yeah, a little really? Over an hour. That's it? Yeah.
Oh, well, then I think we have time.
All right, let's do a Mad Lib. We're going to do a Mad Libs.
If that's
we're
okay
gonna...
with the guest, if that's okay for Sean.
We're going to do...
Oh, I suppose.
All right, all right. People have been saying, we're going to do a Mad Libs, we're going to do a Mad Libs. All right, we're going to do a Mad Lib. All right, so chat room, I need you to give me an adjective and a body part that's plural. I need a plural body part and an adjective.
Attack beard.
Attack beard? That's not necessarily...
That'd be a body part.
I will put that under... Well, we also need another body part. So I'll put that... Since it's singular, I'll put that under the other body part that we're going to need. Attack beard.
Furry balls.
Furry ball. So furry... Well, see, Toasty's trying to double up. See, I got toes. I got balls. Zia, I need a color from you.
Okay.
And Sean, I need an adjective ending in EST.
Okay.
Booger green.
Huh? Booger green? Booger green. All right.
Greatest.
Greatest. All right. All right. So I'm let's see. Well, I see a skanky from Adams. That's... Oh, I hate that word. Well, let's see. We got teeth. We got toes. We got furry balls. Like, what should I use for the body part plural?
Here. Clitori.
Clitori? Like yes. Multiple?
Yes, that's a funny word.
All right, so clitori. Well, I still need the adjective. What adjective am I going to use here?
Oh, Kobe Panda said that was for the superpower power, not the actual body part. Okay, so we can get rid of attack here, even though that's fucking funny.
Yeah, I like that a lot, actually.
Yeah.
We're going to use that for the body part. Fuck it. We're going to use attack
here. Does it make sense? Like
I don't know. We're going to find out. We're going to find out. Fuck it. Shit. I still need an adjective. Am I going to use fur? Do I use furry, skanky?
Furry or skanky, either one.
How about lumpy?
Lumpy.
All right, we'll go sticky. Sticky. That's... All right. All right, now I need, chat room, I need you guys to give me a noun and an animal plural. So Zia, I need, Zia and Sean, I need three adjectives. Three. Okay.
Do you want to go first?
It doesn't matter. You guys just
start. You go ahead. I'm having hurt. I'm sitting here thinking.
I just need three adjectives.
Enormous.
Hard.
Okay. I see zebras. I'm going to badgers. Oh, badgers. Tacos are not an animal. Oh, can use them as a noun though. Tacos can be the noun. I'll use tacos as a noun.
How about voluptuous?
That's a good one.
Voluptuous. All right. And I just need an animal plural, fruit flies. Or so do I use badgers, zebras, or fruit flies? What do you guys want?
Badgers are kind of... I like badgers.
Badgers. All right.
All right. We're going with badgers. All right. Here we go. Ready? This is called dragons. The booger green dragon is the greatest dragon of all. It has sticky clitori. And an attack beard shaped like a taco. It loves to eat badgers, although it will feast on nearly anything. It is enormous and hard. You must be voluptuous around it, or you may end up as its meal.
Which is exactly what you don't want to be. It's nice and voluptuous.
There you go. The dragon has sticky clitori. All right. So that is it.
Clitoris, he said stinky clitori. So,
I like how the attack bear is shaped like a taco.
Yeah.
I can just put that in my head for some reason.
This dragon's just one big fucking vagina. Just like.
But he's hard.
That's hard. Yeah.
It's a hard booger.
All right.
So no reviews, so let's get into our haikus.
Sounds good.
Big titties and ass. She wants to be inside you. Haikus from Zia.
Replacement for Ray. And I better watch my back. I'll get replaced too. especially after tonight.
And of course, chat room, if you have any haikus, we will be glad to read it. I am drawing a blank for my my 7 at the moment.
Okay.
I'm just drawing a complete blank here on
something regarding
our guest. Yes.
Oh god.
He's a sultry voice. He's a Ray's replacement. He raids hard. He's going to be wrangling. He's going to be herding cats in November for us.
See?
Seriously? I don't know if you might change your mind.
No, they're going to change their mind when they meet me. That's what's going to
happen. This guy's.
All right. I think I got it. All right.
Let's hear him.
Fucking VIP. Sean raids more than Maticus. Sticky clitori.
All right, we got 2 from Joe Brewer in the chat room. We got Ray has been replaced. Vel brings the high-end game here. He can walk the edge. Whoa! And then he says, Zia throws some salt. Sarah wants to reach through the screen. Just blame the hormones.
That's right. Fuck you, hormones.
It's true. I have my moments. I really didn't mean to sound so harsh when I said it. It came out so harsh.
It really did.
It meant to be a joke, and it came out like really bitchy. Sorry.
We're going to get like a review of like, Zia made Sarah just walk off the show. And
this
I don't
is
know.
Chicken. We just run out of
fucking
bitch.
Dungeons and Dragons podcast. And
she's a, yeah. It really did come out worse than I meant it to. But
all right, so who
stuck it out?
Yeah, who hung out with us?
Who stuck it out in this craziness?
A few more people hung out with us.
Yeah. We got Adam, Barr, Broom, Chef, EC, Joe B, Kobe, Loki, Opus, Poikle, Rob, Riker. I'm sorry. We're just Rye. I don't know why I'm saying their full name. Stacy! I really haven't seen Stacy in a while. Thunder, Toasted, Proushty Can, Twin Blade, Dan. Val, again, Sean, because he's awesome, and Velvet Dove.
All right. So, Sean, where can people find you and all of your fun stuff?
Well, you can find me on Twitter. It's going to be at Veliice, and no one knows how to spell it. So it is Veliice, like Veliice. Kind of, I guess. I don't know.
Like,
it's actually a place
like Vanilla Ice.
It's actually a place in the United States, and it used to be like an old Greek god. So there you go. Double thing. I actually have a show of my own that I host, a little show called The Edge. It's a World of Warcraft podcast.
Good show.
Pretty good stuff. We have Matt on there from Blizzard Watch. Katie's on there. She's a YouTuber. She works for TGN. And then we have another guy over there, Will, who used to work for TankSpot back in the day. I mean, all really highly educated people, high-end people that a lot of us are kind of in the know and stuff. And it's really cool. So come check us out. You can find us over at twitch.tv/TheEdgePodcast every Tuesday night, 8 p.m. Eastern. We would love to see you all join in live. And then, obviously, D20 with these guys, D20 D20 Crypt.
Yeah.
So.
Oh. We have another haiku from Loki. Seraphis got a big head. Zia's getting big boobs. Veliice has a big mic. And he's happy to see you.
It's like a big black dick in my face. So it makes me sound good.
Peni.
Be
we've had clitori, now we're going to have peni. Yep. There you go.
Is the name of tonight's show Zia Pops Sarah's Ego Stroke Balloon?
That's a long ass title, but.
Oh, man.
Maybe we just call it the Ego Stroke. Or Stroke Balloon. That sounds kind of bad.
It does sound bad.
The Stroke Balloon. Well. You can, if you like this show and I didn't scare you off.
Well, hold on. You can find me on Twitter at Seraphis and.
Oh, well, I was going to say for Ray, because
Ray
is.
Well, that's what I was going to say. Then Rayfist, who's not here, you can follow him on Twitter at Rayfist. Mm-hmm. If you have Xbox or Steam, add him on there. Also Rayfist, R-A-Y-F-Y-S-T. And Zia, now.
You can find me on Twitter at ITSXIA, and you can find the show on all kinds of really, really crazy places. We are on the interwebs at thesundering.net. Oh.
Stop. Sean posted up a haiku in the chat room. He didn't even read it. Son of a bitch didn't even read it. He posted it. No, no, no. You're going to read your own haiku right now.
I wrote, the Sundering crew kicks ass, but Seraphis is better at work, though. I'll still come back on. that's the 575 now, huh?
All right. All right. Anyway, now you can... No, I'm not... No, Adam's not doing it. Anyway, Zia, go ahead and continue.
And you can also follow Bird on...
God on damn it!
if you like Bird RP or you like Ray, you can find him there. Love you, Sarah. All right, so sundering.net. We are also on Twitter at The Sundering. You can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/thesundering, along with... and then you can also find this show in its video format, along with previous episodes, at youtube.com/thesunderingpodcast. We have a phone number. Feel free to give us a ring at 323-SENDER-0 or 323-786-3370. Be warned that if you leave a really long message, we'll splice it together, and you may sound like you're getting ready to pass out and having a very long inner monologue. And you can email the show at thesunderingpodcast@gmail.com. Don't forget, we're having a photo contest, and you can win some free shit. Because awesomeness.
All you got to do is take a picture with your phone and email it. Yeah. It's actually really fucking easy.
It's really that easy. We are, and as Sean mentioned, we are a member of D20 Catalyst, part of the D20 Crit Network, where you can find all kinds of really awesome shows and content and what have you. And finally, our intro is courtesy of Boxing Box. Because ska music.
Sick.
Sick. All right. Thank you, everyone, for spending FOF tonight and questions to our wonderful, awesome guest. Thank you for coming on to the show.
It's me.
Yeah. Fucking download us. Invite us into your home, your ears, your head. We just want to be inside of you.
Next time, we podcast from the Booger Green Dragon's Lair. I'm pushing the wrong button.
Shit, I could have made a fucking better episode.
You're still here? It's over. Go home. Go.
I rolled a 20.